Shalom to David Crombie, Crown Heights, New York.
Shalom. Good evening. How are you?
So you know we're hearing all the reports, the numbers, the pictures from your area. Tell us about the atmosphere, the feeling that you're feeling these days there.
It's really hard to tell what's the atmosphere in the area since we're all being home. We all quarantined. We can't leave the house. What we hear in the news, it's pretty much similar to yours. It's just very often people that we actually know, people that we davened with, people that we share a community life with. It's heartbreaking. It's really terrible. There's no words to describe the feeling of the community. It's devastating. It's depressing. And we pray every day that it's going to be over.
Now, in terms of the amount of infections, I understand that it's practically everywhere.
But it's true. So look, I don't have the numbers. I don't know numbers, but just from people that I speak to, from friends that I have in the community, it's hard to say, but in almost every house that I've been speaking to, there is at least one person who was positive for Corona, which is really, it's hard to believe. We know by now already that we were one of the first communities to get hit with that. So we also hope to be the first one to get over it, with obviously as less death as possible, as least death as possible. But every single home, including my home, has at least one person who had it at some point. I have to say that the majority of the people, the majority of the community, the young people, the healthy adults, will get over it. It's uncomfortable. It's not easy. It's not fun. Nobody wants to get it, but they will survive. The elderly population is obviously who's being affected in the worst ways. And we saw some very important people in the community who passed away.
Now, you know, David, in Israel, the state takes control. There's fines and police patrols. And of course, the Shabak is even sending text messages to people to stay in quarantine. By you, it sounds like it's more self or communal disciplines.
Right, 100%. So from when my wife got tested positive, for example, she didn't get any special text like you're getting in Israel that you have to be quarantined for 14 days and can't leave the house or anything like that. Goes without saying that all the businesses are closed, nobody's going to work, transportation obviously is limited, but there is no shutdown in the same sense that there is in Israel from what I'm hearing about what's going on in Israel. It's mainly right now, in our community at least, is everyone following what the Rabbanim has been saying, and they've said to stay home, not go to work, regardless if you feel good or not. Realistically speaking, the numbers of people who actually would check positive for Corona and they've been tested is much more significant than the actual numbers that they tell us on the media. There is no like a set in stone rule for people who were tested positive or anything like that. It's just more like, okay, you positive, stay home for 14 days or wait until your symptoms are over and then count 7 days and only then you'll be able to go.
Now, in terms of the Haredi community, was there really a shift in terms of the awareness, in terms of the actions?
In our community in particular, there was a tremendous difference the first few days of this outbreak up till now. At the beginning, I have to say, just like I'm sure it's well known, people didn't exactly understand what's going on, didn't exactly know, didn't exactly follow the news. There wasn't like an exact guidelines. Even the president wasn't so clear about what to do and what's going to happen. But down the line, I think this is one of the first communities who got up and said, we have to stop, close down shop. All the shuls, the schools, the organization, the events, the weddings, everything was canceled that same day. Obviously, it took people a few more days to adopt. This community in particular also started the Sefer Torah campaign, which I'm sure you know of. So that's the general Sefer Torah for the entire Klal Yisrael, for everyone to partake.
You're mentioning the Torah scroll. I understand that the initiative, the idea, comes from a Hasidic story from the Baal Shem Tov.
Yeah, it comes from an old story. It says about the Baal Shem Tov. It's been brought down that there was a over there that took place and they needed to stop, and they went to the Baal Shem Tov. Baal Shem Tov said, look, I don't have the magic remedy. I don't have anything, any magic idea to give you. The only thing I can tell you is that once writing a Sefer Torah and guiding the Klal Yisrael and keeping up the good spirit of the Sefer Torah, that's the only thing that's going to stop it. I'm not going to give you all the details of the story, but in short, that's the idea. So they already wrote 70,000 letters in this Sefer Torah from people in our community and other communities in the U.S. and now they're obviously coming to Israel as well.
Tell us about the responses to this initiative.
We get an incredible feedback. The organizers are getting an insane amount of feedback. People, it's a free thing. You can go and buy a letter for free. But people donating and people helping and people sharing on their social media and everywhere, it's getting an incredible feedback, mainly because nobody has a cure for this. And this might actually be the only cure.
So, David, here's something positive coming out of these challenging days.
Yes, Rabbi Jacobson said, I think yesterday in a broadcast, that at the time of war, you see the worst in people, but you also see the best of them. So this is one of these times that we actually see the best in the Jews around the world. And it's the one other thing that's going to unite us all together. Mr. Shem, for the ultimate redemption for Pesach.
David Crombie, Crown Heights, New York. Thank you very much and good luck.
Pleasure speaking to you. Thank you so much.